Red Devil Cichlid, there's a reason why this fish got that name. A beautiful but violent cichlid, which gets quite large when it matures and is very aggressive and territorial. Many Red Devils develop a dog-like relationship with their owners, and some will even let their owners pet them. Red Devils are an amazing species but aren't easy to care by any means. This is highly recommended only for experienced fish keepers, and beginners should stay away, as this fish might not be as good as they look. So watch this ultimate care guide till the end, so that you are aware of the care requirements. Welcome to Finding Fishes, let's get started. The Red Devil Cichlid, also scientifically known as Amphilophus labiatus, is often confused with the Mytis cichlid. They are a member of the Cichlidae family. It is native to Central America, near the Atlantic Ocean towards Nicaragua. It dominates most Nicaraguan lakes, like Managua, Ziloa and Nicaragua. The average Red Devil Cichlid lifespan is around 10 to 12 years, and they can grow up to 15 inches in size. They are aggressive in nature, and require intermediate level of care. Red Devil Cichlids are very conscious of their owners. They are charismatic and energetic fish. However, they do not do well with other fish. This includes fish of the same species. Red Devil Cichlids are very aggressive. They're territorial, and will attack other fish in the tank. Furthermore, you'll often find the fish trying to destroy anything that they can get their mouths on. When they're not fighting with other fish or destroying non-protected items in the tank, Red Devil Cichlids will do a lot of swimming. They need plenty of room to explore. We recommend keeping the center of the tank relatively open so that they can move around freely. This is a large Central American cichlid, and it needs a lot of room. A 55-gallon aquarium is the minimum suggested for a single fish, with 125 gallons needed for a pair, and 200 gallons if keeping several large cichlids. They need moderate water movement along with strong efficient filtration. Provide a bottom of fine sand, and plenty of hiding places among rocks and wood. They are avid diggers, and plants don't fare so well as they will be eaten, shredded or uprooted. Make sure rocks are well bedded on the actual glass bottom of the tank to prevent toppling. While it is important to provide Red Devils with plenty of hiding places and plants, it is equally important to provide an open center area for them to swim in. They need a water temperature of around 75 to 79 degrees Fahrenheit and pH level of 6.5 to 7.5. Since they are omnivorous, the Red Devil Cichlid will generally eat all kinds of live, fresh, and flake foods. To keep a good balance, give them a high-quality flake food or pellet every day. Feed high-quality cichlid pellets, krill, frozen bloodworms, earthworms, night crawlers, crickets, spirulina-based foods, and carotene-enhanced supplements. They do need vegetable-based foods to prevent hole-in-the-head disease and to complete a balanced diet. Be careful when feeding your cichlid warm-blooded mammal meats, as these meats have amounts and types of proteins and fats not normally found in a cichlid's diet. These foods can therefore cause intestinal blockages and organ degradation in cichlids. If you find your fish enjoys these types of foods, be sure to only feed them as an occasional treat, not as a dietary staple. There are no special diseases that are exclusive to the Red Devil Cichlid. However, these fish are susceptible to diseases that commonly affect freshwater fish. One of the most common issues aquarists have to deal with is ick. This condition is highly contagious and can lead to death if untreated. It can be treated by raising the tank temperature to about 86 degrees Fahrenheit for about 3 days. Alternatively, you can utilize copper-based medications. In addition to ick, Red Devil Cichlids are prone to hole-in-the-head disease. Also known as head and lateral line disease, this condition causes visible pits on the head and face. It's believed that the disease is caused by nutrient deficiencies and poor water quality. Make sure you replace about 25 to 30% of the tank water weekly, and use powerful filters to remove organic matter regularly. Red Devil Cichlids have been bred in captivity for quite some time. It's relatively easy to breed these fish, even for beginners. Thanks to their monogamous nature, you don't have to worry about some common breeding issues. Males and females will protect their young until they are free swimming and ready to fend for themselves. To start the breeding process, raise the tank temperature to about 77 degrees Fahrenheit. This mimics the naturally warm waters during the breeding season in the wild. Feed the fish plenty of nutrient-rich foods, such as bloodworms. When the female is ready to lay her eggs, she will choose a flat rock or inclined substrate. You can provide a breeding area by creating a subtle hill or introducing driftwood into the tank. Females lay between 600 and 700 eggs at once. They're translucent and take on a yellowish-orange tinge. After about 3 to 4 days, the eggs will hatch. The male and female fish may then move the tiny fry to another area of the tank. Sometimes, the male will dig a pit to offer better protection against predators. After another 5 to 7 days, the fry should be able to swim on their own. That's it for today, guys. Hope you really enjoyed the video. Keep supporting us and stay tuned for more such interesting videos. Finding fishes, remember the name.